Hey guys, good morning. Welcome back to my channel. So, good morning guys. Ah, man, good morning. Well done. So, how are you guys doing? How are you guys coping with this, you know, isolation period? What's popping? What's going on? Welcome back to my channel. My name is Adeze. If you're new to this channel and if you're a returning subscriber, thank you so much for coming back. So today is I think today is Friday morning. I don't even know what day it is. I don't know what day of the month it is. I shall know why April. I think it's second or third, whatever. Anyway, so this morning I want to just make tea for my kids, also make pap for them. Amarachi is folding clothes upstairs, and yeah, so while I do all these things, I want to chat with you guys and just know how you're doing and also give you updates about how I'm doing, because if anybody noticed, I'm sure nobody noticed, Sha, but if anybody noticed, I did not post my usual Tuesday and Friday videos. I only posted on Sunday, and that's because I was tired. Okay, I was tired. Too many things happened in my life at once. Some changes, actually, my husband's job. So things were just not for the worse. So my husband's job, not for the worse. Well, not for the worse per se, but he was required to spend more time, you know, working than usual, because he's what they call essential personnel or something like essential staff, essential personnel, something like that. So he's required to work longer, he's required to work for a longer period than usual. So it really, I don't know, it started bugging me, because this is a time where I would love to be at home with my husband, like all of us just cozy up together and be quarantining together. But yeah, it's not going to work that way for now. But I know I have to be grateful, okay? I have to be grateful that he has a job at least where he's considered as important in, because the way the times are going, man, the way the times are going, you better hope that in your job they can you know, they cannot do without, not they cannot do without you, but at least you are higher on the rank of people that they cannot not do without. Okay, I don't know what I just spoke now, but I know you guys understand me. Okay, so yeah, so I'm grateful to God for that part. Okay, I'm grateful for everything. Anyway, let me not even just talk rubbish this morning, but yeah, I just wish some things could be different. But I guess wishing some things could be different also means that you're wishing that some other good things would be different too. So let me stop talking about that part before I start talking blah blah blah. Anyway, so let me put the water on fire for my zoo. Let me put the water. Yeah, so but generally life has been very good, you know. I can't complain. Well, provided for, I thank God, like I said, I thank God for my husband's kind of job, and I also thank God that I have YouTube to come to connect with people, you know, to have fun, you know, to provide some kind of, I don't know, entertainment for anybody who finds me entertaining. So yeah, I'm just grateful to God for that, and also the ability to also earn a little bit from YouTube, because YouTube revenue, in case you don't know, YouTube revenue just took a pew nosedive, and which is expected, because I mean, many companies are you know, either closed or stuff like that. So not many people are advertising at this point. Not even, we won't have an advertising budget at this point, because everybody's just trying to survive. Okay, I heard that they are laying off a lot of people and all that, which is really sad. Like, I've tried a little bit to not watch the news so much, not listen to what people, you know, not go on social media and listen to the news so much. I tried a lot not to do that, because the more I listen to it, the more I hear the news, the more I hear what's going on, the more I'm just like God, just take control. Because hi baby, remove your hand from your mouth, okay? You want to come and stay with me? Come, let me make tea for you, okay? Yeah, so the more I think about it, the more I'm just like, how are people coping out there? People who live from hand to mouth, people who don't really have much to survive on, how are they coping? You want to say hi? Okay, say hi.
Hi.
Yeah. Yeah, so the more I think about it, the more it really bothers me. You know, you guys know now that I used to cry people's matter on my head. So it's like, I mean, I'm okay. I thank God for my life. But other people out there, uncle, when I think about how people are coping this period, I'm just like, God, what's going on? I wish I was one billionaire that could just give out, you know, not just money but relief materials, food, water, you know, fuel, or just buy, you know, some kind of generator for a community or something. I don't know, but I just wish I could do more. And I'm also going to try and do more, okay? It's not about wishing I was a billionaire. Wherever, at whatever stage you are, there's something you can do to help the next person. You are always better off than somebody, okay? No matter who you think you are, no matter how much you think is in your account, there's someone who has less than you, so you can always afford to share or afford to, even if it's render your services or something, there's always something you can do, okay? So I'm going to find a way to really help people. For right now, monitoring, we've used up our money trying to stock up the house, because this was like 3 or 4 months. We bought things for almost 3 months or so. So yeah, but whenever the next time I get money, I'm going to try and do something for people. Yeah, but generally we've been good, okay? I was telling someone that, see, this isolation life has been my normal lifestyle for years, so there's really nothing new. It's not really a major adjustment. The only problem is that, you know, when you cannot do something, that is when you absolutely want to do it. When you're now told, okay, you cannot do this, that's when your whole system wants to do that, okay? So yeah, but aside that, we've been good, okay? It's almost like this is no longer a drill. This is what we've been practicing for, this is what you've been trained for. So this is no longer a drill, this is time to it's time to, you know, your sister is telling me, no, this is, it's time, okay? It's time, because basically, aside going to the market or taking my kids to school, I wasn't really going anywhere. Like, there's really nothing. Now school has closed, okay, and we still have shops around there, and I have food at home, so I wasn't really going anywhere. I make my kids' hair, I make my own hair, like not braids and stuff, but I have, if I want to wash my hair now, I have my shampoo, my conditioner, my blow dryer, my straightener, my Benji rollers, hair cream, all sorts of hair products. I have them in this house. In my husband's own case, he has been cutting his hair for years. Since I met him, he has been cutting his hair himself. So, you know, that was not a problem at all. Like I said, I make my kids' hair, I can make a matching hair by myself if I want to. So there's really nothing when it comes to all this plumbing and electrical work around the house. My husband has been taking care of those things for the longest time. So, you know, like I said, for us, we're balling. This is our normal lifestyle, you know. There's this meme about when your normal lifestyle is called isolation. Like, okay. Or called quarantine. All right. So yeah, that's it about how we are coping. This past week has just been one kind. Amarachi fell ill. She had some fever. When she told me she had the fever, I was just like, okay, sis. But it turned out that the fever was symptoms of malaria. So yesterday I got her drugs and all that, even though she didn't even take the drugs eventually, because she said she feels fine. But I had to buy the malaria drug. I don't want to hear, you know, not want to hear anything, okay? So I'm also giving her vitamin C, 1000 milligrams, so that to just help her immunity. Same as I'm giving my kids two vitamin C. I don't know how many milligrams I give them. No, I give them 5 ml. I don't know how many milligrams that is. 5 ml 3 times a day or 2 times a day. Well, yeah, so that's it. I also take vitamin C 1000. Well, when I remember, but yeah, okay. So, yeah, so but because she's not feeling well, I've been the one doing a lot of things. I now do a lot more things than I used to do in the house, you know, so that she can rest. And just her work basically now is just to stay with the children, okay? Once you stay with them and all of you are fine, I can do every work in the house. But once the children start disturbing me, you know, yeah, it's not really that easy. So I've been talking here, the tea I say I want to do, I've not even started this. Please, I'm coming. These are my kids' teacups, very cute. Very cute cups. Let me see. This colors me. Okay, so yeah, I'm making Milo for my kids. I use sachet Milo because anytime I buy the refill or the what they call it now, the can. Anytime I buy the can or the refill, I notice that the way the thing finishes in this house, I'm just like, what's going on? What's going on? People think that thing is it's for play. So I decided to buy sachet. So anybody that drink, you know, that one sachet is for the, I actually share one sachet for the two kids, because this thing is whether 60% sugar or something. So yeah, this thing is like 40% or 60% sugar. So I share one sachet for the two kids. Every other person just takes one. So, but I mean, by if you need more, you take two. But when you're taking two, just use your conscience. Let your conscience tell you whether two is enough or too much. Okay, that's why I buy the sachet. Although it's just a matcha and the kids that drink Milo, though. Me, I don't drink. Milo, I drink coffee, which is funny because chocolate is almost like my best flavor of ice cream. You know, I love chocolate a lot, but when it comes to Milo, I don't know, it just tastes too sugary to me, I guess. Yeah, tastes too sugary for an adult. I feel it tastes too sugary for an adult, but for kids, it's okay. Like I said, they take two different milks, which I'm beginning to think now that it's just too much. Okay, Cora takes 4-5-6, pick one, 4-5-6. Eva takes pick 1-2-3. Nello, my friend Nello, Nello KK says that she doesn't care about, you know, milk. She can drink any type of milk. Me, I care about milk. Oh, ah, like there's a difference. There's a difference. I'm a pick kind of girl. Okay, I love pick milk. I love pick powder, pick liquid. For liquid milk, I can even manage. But you see, powdered milk, that's when I cannot manage at all, because you can. I don't know. I don't have to explain it. But I take powdered milk for basically cereal. So I can taste the milk, you know. It's not like it's in coffee. We are not really tasting the milk itself, but in cereal you can taste the milk. So for cereal, I just love pick powder. So yeah, I'm done with their tea and I'll be right back. Okay, so just stay tuned. Okay, so yeah, this period I've been, you know, reflecting a lot about my channel, about life, about so many things, okay, and the kind of content that I put out. I know you guys love vlogs, you guys love chit chat videos like this, but me personally, the kind of videos that I love vlogs and I love chit chat, but I think the kind of videos that I love more are videos where I'm discussing really serious issues that is affecting us as women, you know, affecting our community, but affecting especially women. 2 days ago, or was it 3 days ago, I was on a live stream with Obese Aura on Instagram. If you guys don't know who Obese Aura is, like, and you're a woman, so who are you following? Can you please tell me who you are following on Instagram if you are not following Obese Aura, okay? Yeah, so I love her a lot. I love her a lot. I've made so many of my friends follow her. Okay, there's some things that she says that my man are just like, sister, I'm not sure I can live up to what you're expecting also. But generally, like, she's one of those people. She's someone that me, I refer to as a true influencer, okay? True, real life positive influencer, okay? So many women have been impacted by, you know, being on her page. Their lives have been changed, you know. But when I say true influencer, I mean she really influences you. There's so many things now that before I do, I just think of her, like, subconsciously I just think of so many things that when I want to say, I think of her. So many things that when I see, I think of her immediately. So yeah, she's a true influencer. Anyway, this is not about to be anyway. So yeah, I was on a live stream with her 2 days ago. I wasn't on the live stream, I was watching a live stream of her with another Instagram person. The name of the person's company is She Clothed also. So they do, I think, loans for women and stuff like that. Anyway, I started sweating. Okay, so yeah, let me start making the pap. Anyway, so they were now talking about, you know, finances and positioning yourself to recover better from this. Wait. Okay. Ah, I thought my pap was smelling odd. Yay. You guys, this pap is one I make myself. I have like two more containers inside the freezer, but I'm now mizing it first. I really don't start making pap in this kind of period. I'm not in the mood then, because if I have to do that, I have to go and blend it at the what they call it. Those people that blend stuff, and that's not what I'm interested in right now. Anyway, so yeah, talking about positioning yourself to be better, to come out better, you know, after this whole Rona thing, and, you know, talking about women and their finances, and so many things they said in that live stream. Even though Obese is an entrepreneur and the other person is, and also, okay, they're both entrepreneurs, okay, you know, they were saying exactly. There's so many things that I always say to women, okay, and that is, See, for me personally, I've said this thing before. I really don't care about when people are saying, oh, you must find something doing, stay at home mom, this one, don't be a stay at home mom, find something doing, find something doing. My mind, I'm just like, okay, it's not about finding something doing, it's about how well are you managing your finances. A stay at home mom can be in a better position financially than a woman that is running out of her house 5 a.m. coming 9 p.m. Okay, it is what it is. It's not even about how much you are earning. It is about how much you are saving and investing. You guys know that I'm all about savings and investment. I'm all about it. Like, I've not talked about piggy vest here before. So that reminds me, if you, I have a link for you to save with piggy vest. And when you use my link, you're going to be given 1,000 naira free to start your savings, okay? But if you've already registered, you've been given that 1,000 naira, but you're not going to get it except you start saving. Not just register, you have to start saving at least 100 naira. So even if you're transferring 100 naira every day to the account, or 200 naira, or 500 naira, 1,000, or how much, whatever amount you want to transfer to the account, you have to transfer it and start saving with them before you can get that 1,000 naira. So, because I've seen so many people that I can see that their money is just hanging because they don't start saving. So, if you want to start saving with piggyvest, make sure you sign up with my link and then start saving on the account, okay? So yeah, I always talk about saving and investment because at the end of the day, how much do you have to fall back on if anything bad happens? We keep telling women, you need to start working, you need to make, have something doing, you need to get a business, you need to get a job, you know, what if something happens to the husband, blah, blah, blah. There are so many women who have jobs and who have businesses that if something happens to their husbands today, they are still going to suffer, okay? They're still going to be suffer because you have a job where if you lose your husband today, your job cannot sustain you and your family. It's just the truth. Your job cannot sustain you and your family. Your business that was, or guy was even holding up by paying you. Anyway, I've talked so much about this in a video that I'll post before or after this. It's about my thoughts on being a stay-at-home mom and stuff like that. So you guys should definitely go and check out that video where I discuss all these things in detail. But yeah, so it's all about your finances. You know, many of us, and it's something that was highlighted. Aeroplane, come and pass now. So people have seen moving up and down. So they say people should not be going up and down. Aeroplane is still passing. So yeah, one thing to talk about in that live stream, which I have been thinking about for a while, is the fact that so many women do not have any form of pension. Even those who are working, even those who have businesses, you know, they don't have any form of pension, they don't have any form of savings that, you know, they can live on in their old age. I always say this thing that my goal is that in my old age, I'll be living on the interest from the money that I have saved, not even from my money I've saved, from the interest of the money that I have saved, okay? So, but many women don't have pension. So, in crisis like this, in things like this, you see that women are going to be the worst hit. Because at the end of the day, you don't have any pension, you don't have any plans for your future, you are living on the now. Yes, you are earning money, but you are earning money just to live now. You are earning money just to wear the latest hair, just to wear the latest clothes, just to buy H&B, just to travel, just to buy this phone and that. That's all you are earning money for. You're not saving anything. You're not, you're just trying to keep up with a lifestyle that, to be honest, nobody gives a shit about. nobody really cares, okay? Nobody really cares. At the end of the day, once you own yourself, once you own your personality, once you are comfortable in your own skin, the every other person will adjust. But no, so many women just want to, you know, you want to show. The moment you lose your job or you lose your partner, you are stuck. You don't have any money, you don't have anything to fall back on. Your school, your salary cannot even pay one of your child's school fees. One, just one, in the current school they are in now, okay? So you have to step all your children down if anything happens, or you'll be forced to start, you know, looking for assistance from here and there. So these are the things that people should really think about, especially if you're a woman. You need to think about it, okay? Just think about it. So you guys, I didn't mean to become all, you know, philosophical and whatever and inspire to aspire. Okay, I didn't mean to become all motivational this morning, but to be honest, these are things that I want us to discuss, and I'm going to be discussing more of them on my channel, because at the end of the day, these are the things that really matter, okay? Yes, entertainment is good, you know, having fun, laughing, being happy is good, but will you be happy if, see this thing, we go home now, yeah? Is it because I'm making tea? You want to go and buy your own tea? So anyway, yeah, entertainment is good, it's good to be happy, but at the end of the day, will you be happy will you be happy if your finances are bad, okay? Will you be happy if there's no money for you to survive on? Will you be happy? So yeah, so this is the thing I'm talking about in my video. The words of my friend Josh Too Funny. I don't know him personally, but I just like the guy, okay? In the words of Josh Too Funny, okay, jot things down so that you can take things away, okay? Jot things down so that you can take things away. Okay, yeah. So I want to have content like that where people would literally be compelled to jot things down so that they can take things away. Okay, yeah, so that's it though. Yeah, I'm currently trying to make my kids pop. So you guys, that reminds me, like 4 or 5 days ago, I was going to change the gas at the back of the house and I mistakenly hit my head at, you know this, let me even show you guys where I hit my head. This is literally where I hit my head. I'm actually taller than this, but I wanted to bend. I didn't know that I did not bend well enough. So this corner, let me see if I even see blood on it. I've not seen.
Ooh, hello son, hello son.
So yeah, when I say actually hit my head, like I hit my head really bad. It was bleeding, you know, the pain was just what they call the name, I had a throbbing pain, okay? The pain was throbbing, okay? So yeah, it's better now. I don't feel the pain anymore, but well, I still feel the pain if I touch it, or if for some reason I lie on that side, or if I move my eyebrows. You know when you move your eyebrows, your scalp, I'm sure many of you are doing it as I'm doing it. Yeah, when you move your eyebrows, your scalp kind of squeezes. So when my scalp squeezes, I feel the pain. But yeah, and it really sucks, okay? It really sucks. I was planning to lose my hair and wash it, and then this thing happened. So I need to allow the hair to heal, the scalp to heal, before I lose my hair or even start trying to wash it. The hair is already old, but it doesn't look so bad. But yeah, the hair is old. Okay, so I want to just make a small drink for myself. Just something to get my system going this morning. I wanted to make coffee, but I've been drinking too much coffee these days. I mean, it's not like I'm trying to stay awake for anything, but I don't know. So I'm trying to slow down on my coffee intake. So I'm just going to make a little drink with ACV, ginger. This is ginger that I made myself, and lemon juice. So just those three things. Ever since I started saving lemon in mason jars, it has been a lifesaver, because sometimes lemons can spoil easily. So I think I'll add a little bit of zobo here. You know what, let me just calm down the zobo. Let me just drink it like that. I'm drinking it cold instead of warm. I'm drinking it cold. I don't know. All right, so guys, I'm done with my drink. This is just ginger, lemon and apple cider vinegar. And yeah, don't be fooled by how it looks. So it tastes like liquid death. Make juice for my kids and keep in the fridge while I drink, you know, the fiber, the pulp, the chaff, whatever. Anyway, so that's what I usually make for my kids. I have a video coming out where I'll show you guys how I made this, how I packed this like this, for me to be able to give them fresh juice, you know, whenever I want to during this period. Especially now that, you know, we don't really go out that much and we don't really even want to go out that much. Yeah, so I'm going to I have a video coming out how I made this, but I'm just quickly make the juice for them. And yeah, I think I'll show you guys the process. First of all, this thing is frozen. I bought it from the freezer, so I'm going to chop it up to make it smaller. I actually made them in big chunks, and somehow my blender, you know, it makes it difficult for my blender to blend it. I have a blender that is just good for nothing. So I'm just going to chop it a little more and then blend it straight. I'll show you guys, okay? So yeah, just stay tuned. I'm making your juice.
Our juice?
Yes.
Our juice is disgusting.
It's not disgusting to your head. I put Nutri-C in their juice because anytime I make it without extra sweetness, Cora does not like to drink it. If I even manage it, but Cora does not drink it. You guys just heard what she said. So that's why I always add Nutri-C
Mommy,
to her own.
Fire,
I mean, it's also added, even though it's added sugar, it's also added vitamin C. So, yeah. Hi, Ava.
Mommy, don't.
Say hello, guys. Say hello, guys. They're giving us cheese ball. Okay. Hi, Ava.
I need my cheese ball.
All right, guys. So I'm in my room now. Please ignore the sound. You're hearing any sound at the back? It's actually the fan. This room is kind of hot, and I'm even facing the fan somewhere else, so the noise and the breeze doesn't affect the audio. But yeah, you guys should just manage. Like, I hope you guys can hear me clearly, and I hope you guys can manage the audio. Anyway, so you guys, this is going to be my 100th upload. Yay! This is my 100th upload. I've uploaded 99 videos so far, so this is going to be the number 100. Like, you guys, it's so exciting to think I've uploaded 100 videos. Like, you know, sometimes when you start, you're like, how am I going to get enough content to keep going? I mean, now I feel like I've not even done enough, and I'm at 100 uploads already. So yeah, I'm excited for the future. Thank you guys so much for sticking with me, for enjoying my content, if you do. And if you don't, hopefully something else would, you know, interest you, and I plan to do more moving forward. Okay, so about my kids, I've been seeing online people that are teaching their kids, they're homeschooling their kids, they have several different activities for their kids are doing this and doing that and creating this and creating that. Me, my own kids are just jobless. My own kids are just at home playing, eating, watching TV. My kids right now are free range kids. Okay, and initially I wanted to start feeling bad, like, I'm not doing enough. Oh, let my kids not forget what they've learned in school. And I'm just like, you know what, let's just rest. Everybody's gonna be fine. Last, we're all going to be okay. Okay, like, I'm tired. I just want to rest. So my kids right now are just free range kids. They're just roaming up and down, no schedule, nothing to do. But actually, the only thing that we've kept is just their morning and evening routine. Morning routine, and what I mean by morning routine is that basically they have their bath in the morning and change, and then they have breakfast. Then in the evening, they have their meals and then have their bath, and then we now try to get them to sleep, but they don't really sleep. Ava does not sleep till like 10, 11 p.m. Cora sleeps like maybe 8, 9, but Ava does not sleep till like 10, 11 p.m., okay, because she usually sleeps in the afternoon sometimes. Sometimes she doesn't even sleep in the afternoon. So at this point, I'm just like, I don't know how you mothers are doing it. To those of you that have a routine, you have, you know, your kids have these activities and those activities. I don't know how you guys are doing it. My kids are just winging it. We're all winging it in this house. Last night, we could do all right. I saw one thing they posted on Instagram yesterday about if after this period, you don't come out with a side hustle or a new skill or a business idea or whatever, then it excuses you had not a time problem or something. I'm just like, can you just allow us be? Can we just rest? Can we breathe? Can we just survive this thing first? How about let us come out alive first before we're coming out with a skill and a this and that? Let us come out alive first, okay? So now the same thing with my kids. Like let's just enjoy ourselves first, okay? Because throughout the year, they're usually working, and again, they're supposed to be on break this period or so, or very soon. They are about to close in their school before, so this is literally break period. They should rest. They'll be fine. All of us will be fine. Okay, all of us will be fine. Yeah, so I talked too much. I thought it was going to be like 2 hours long. Anyway, so yeah, I'd like to know video suggestions. What you guys want us to talk about? If you have any Q&A for me, if you want me to do a Q&A, let me know in the comment section and then ask me questions there. Or if you want us to discuss any topic in particular, please put the topic in the comment section, because
It's only discuss we can discuss. I cannot show you guys anywhere. I just really know where to go to. It's only discuss we can discuss. So please leave comments in the comment section telling me what kind of videos you love to see, what kind of topics you want us to discuss. Anyway, thank you guys so much for watching. If you like this video, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel, please. And I'll see you all in my next video, guys. Bye, guys.